Hello everyone, this is Jen from Old Tinkerer Studio. Today I'm going to do a quick Photoshop CC tutorial on making a quick mask border. This is an example of what we're going to be making. I'll have the link to this particular image down in the description section. Okay, so go to File, Open, and open up your image. Go to your Layers panel and click on the lock to unlock the back, the layer. And then we're going to make it into a smart object by going to the drop-down menu and go to Convert to Smart Object. This way we can make changes non-destructively. Add a new layer and make a selection with your Rectangular Marquee tool. Now you want to inverse the selection. You can go to Select and Inverse, or use Shift-Control-I on a Windows or Shift-Command-I on a Mac. Now what we need to do is make the quick mask. Now you can do this by clicking on the quick mask icon over in your Tools panel, or you can just simply hit Q on the keyboard. Now we want to apply the filters onto the quick mask. So go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. And I'm going to use 45 pixels, but you choose whatever pixel number you want and click OK. Then go to Filter, Filter Gallery, and you can play around with any of these and choose whichever one you want. I'm going to stay under the sketch panel and use the water paper. I'm going to use a fiber length of 15, a brightness of 60, and a contrast of 90. But again, go ahead and choose whatever you want. You can make all the changes to whatever looks good to you. When you've finished, click OK. Now we need to exit the quick mask mode, and you can either do that by clicking on the quick mask icon in your tools panel, or again just hitting Q on your keyboard. Now go to your foreground color. You need to pick a foreground color that you want to make the border. I am actually going to be using hex code 9675 09, just kind of a golden brownish color, and click OK. Now we need to fill the selection with the foreground color. You can do this by going to Edit and Fill, or you can use the shortcut of Shift F5. And when you have your fill window open, choose foreground color from your contents and then just click OK. Then deselect the border by either going to Select and then Deselect, or on a Windows you can use Control D, or on a Mac Command D. And there you have it. I hope you found this useful. Have a good day.